My name is Sahaja Mandari, and I work in the same lab as Shabnam, actually, in the cardiovascular fluid mechanics lab under Dr. Yoganathan. He's a pretty big professor in the BME department. So my project is about studying blood damage caused by one prosthetic heart valve. So a little bit of background. As we all know, where's your heart? Right here. And so here's a zoom-in picture. So the heart is divided into four sections, I guess. The right, left atriums, and the right and left ventricles, and then we have four different valves that control the blood flow through the heart. So we have tricuspid, aortic, pulmonary, and mitral. Okay, so we have four different heart valves that control the blood flow through the heart, and then if they're not working, what happens? So one of the big, huge reasons why heart valves are replaced is because they have a disease. They don't open or close properly. It's called stenosis. It's stiffening of the heart muscle, heart valve muscle, which malfunctions the heart valves, and therefore the blood is not regulated properly. So why do we care? Because approximately 20,000 deaths are associated every year because of these diseased heart valves. What do we do when we have diseased heart valves? There's only one solution. You replace them with prosthetic heart valves. So as you can see in the picture, there's like a history of different types of heart valves. You have ball and cage, bileaflet, single disc, and then also bioprosthetic heart valves. So the two main types that the heart valves are divided into are mechanical, which are made out of artificial materials. The other ones are biological valves. They either come from human donors, pretty much probably your dad and just take theirs, or pigs, so those are porcine valves. The one that I'll focus on, because that's what my research is about, is the bileaflet mechanical heart valve. It's one of the best mechanical heart valves because it has the least amount of complications associated with it. So what are the complications? Or before I talk about that, let's talk about how we put in the heart valve. So you have your patient, you cut them up near your, I think it's called the breastbone. You open up the heart and then you hook that person up to a bypass machine, stop the heart for a few seconds, and then remove the diseased valve and put in the prosthetic one. So in this case, the mitral valve is being replaced by the mechanical heart valve. So this procedure is not that complicated. Obviously, you'll have some kind of scar right here if you do go through this procedure. But as you can see before, the heart valve has shrunk because of stenosis, so it's not functioning properly. So after the implantation, you can see how there's enough room for the blood to go through. So the complications that I was talking about are caused by the heart valve because they damage blood. Blood has three different types of cells in them. You have white blood cells, platelets, and red blood cells. As you all know, white blood cells are key to our immunity, and platelets are important because they help clot blood. And then red blood cells, hemoglobin, and blood sugar. So the first risk that I want to talk about is caused because of shear stress caused by the bileaflet mechanical heart valve, where because of shear stress, the red blood cells are squeezed through so they break apart, and that's what hemolysis is. And other risks are thromboembolic complications, which means you have regular red blood cells, and then because of this heart valve, they start to coagulate because of platelet activation. And then one of these clots that are caused by the mechanical heart valve can get loose from where it was began, the source, the valve, and they can go block another blood vessel. That's what thromboembolism means. Because of these complications, patients who have patient to take anticoagulation therapy, which causes, which increases risk of hemorrhage. So the bottom line of all this blood damage to the blood elements is caused due to excessive shear stress caused by the mechanical heart valve. So how do we reduce this? So the actual experimental design is you take the bottle from mechanical heart valve and you try to reduce the shear stress. And you can do this by adding vortex generators onto the lead.